Alright, am I here? Am I coming through? Fan-fucking-tastic. Alright, let's get the show on the road. We'll do a sync here. A, B, C. 1, 2, 3. And thank you. Thank you for the birthday wishes. Hitting level 33. Another year older. Not so much wiser. Just more scared out of my wits. Synced. Alright, let's get this show on the road. Alright, where we last left off, we are now in a segment playing as, I almost said Chris, we're playing as Carlos, and we are now in the RPD. And apparently found out that, Marvin from Resident Evil 2 was in fact bit by a turned Brad Vickers. And in a fitting turn, check out the what I posted from on the Twitter, feed. For any of you who played Resident Evil 7, all right, let's see what we got here. We've got his Glock, got his M4, Brad's ID. Let's get this super weed. Okay. Can I talk to you? No. Where do we go? Go to the Star's office. Okay. Oh, hello. ID security protocols. September 16th, 1998. Each member of the force has been issued an ID card. From now on, the same card will be required to access all storage boxes. Do not lend your card to anyone. Take great care in using it. If your card goes missing, report it lost immediately. Facility maintenance department. So what's in here? All right. I'll take it. Any little leftovers from a certain Barry Burton? Leaving a Magnum around here? Be greatly appreciated. Can I go in here? Frick. Oh, fuck no!
What the hell was that thing?
The Lickers are in here?! Because the Lickers were never in the original. They were only in Resident Evil 2. Resident Evil 3 had Hunters. But I don't think we're at that point just yet. Okay, so we actually see what happens to this guy over here.
Couldn't have been a zombie.
Oh, he's twitching! Can't go through there. Considering that I can't even go through the other door, it's probably not going to be getting any of the suit keys. All
can stick around.
Thank God.
Here we go.
More than double tap. Okay, this place is blue. Damn it! And then somehow you're still alive.
Right. Big, warm RPD welcome.
Gotta use up the super weed already. That barbed wire? That is barbed wire. That TV's still on. So this will probably be like, what, a day before Leon arrives. I think probably at least a day. Careful, don't cause a time paradox. You can't do that! You changed the future! You created a time paradox! Bonus points, whoever gets that reference. Locker room, CP. Oh, they still got the,
You copy? There's something real nasty in here. I don't know what it is.
Something nasty? All right. I'll take a look with the cameras. Watch your six.
They still have the combination locks. Nope, can't go in here. I feel like I have to sneeze, which is a very inopportune time. Oh God. Oh, they went away. Events of RE3 occur one day, and one day after, yeah. Is that with this one, or is that with the original one as well? Both? Okay. Stay down, please. Wait, that's completely cut off? Oh, yeah, that's right. That's the other side that I was thinking. All right, man, you have a good one. Health spray! Hello. Nice. They actually have the names in here. Marvin Brenna, Rita Phillips, Elliot, I think Edwards. It's Leon's desk. David Ford. Yeah. Fun fact, in the original there were the original Resident Evil, the sign here actually had two L's. It was kind of misspelled. Neil Carlson. Okay, this is the, there we go. Elliot Edward. And a safe. We do not have the combination two. Red herb here. I'll take it. Ammo. Anything else here? No. Okay, so I can't even go this way. Okay, so the only... September 20th, arrest report. Rodney Gray, unemployed, former electrician, unlawful creation and or possession of explosives. Suspect was seen behaving suspiciously at 1442 Box Street on September 18th, 1998. Suspect's person was searched, producing a small explosive and a timed detonator from inside his pocket, leading to the arrest on the charges listed above. Search of the subject's home found more than 20 additional homemade explosives of various stages at various stages of completion. Suspect was extremely agitated and not of sound mind. Suspect spoke feverishly when questioning began. At one point, questioning had to be halted due to the sudden bout of shrieking from suspect. Once questioning was resumed, suspect made the following statements. "I didn't do it for me. I did it for you. Why doesn't anyone understand? The corpses attack from the shadows. Storm's coming, but this umbrella is no good. We gotta blow it up, or we'd be more than just wet. Gotta get more bombs. They're coming soon. Gotta hurry. Burn them. Burn the corpses. Burn them good." During questioning, the suspect began to shake violently before resuming a shrieking fit. Questioning was ended and sedative administered. Due to the suspect's unstable psychiatric condition, suspect's testimony was changed from moment to moment. Suspect's delirium made any sort of dialogue impossible. "We are currently awaiting the results of the doctor's investigation into suspect's condition. The explosives collected from the suspect's person and residence appear to be extremely powerful. A safety precaution, the battery was removed from one detonation device upon admission into evidence. The battery was secured in the safety deposit room." Is this the same kind of explosive we used in Resident Evil 2 to blow open that one section up in the roof or the attic? Also, burn him. I'm getting some bad Resident Evil 1 remake vibes. Oh, hi. Oh god, I'm freaking churching it. Stay down, please. Resident Evil 2 theme. Or two red herbs. Internal memo. There we go. 9:15:07. Left 9, right 15, left 7.
Well, if cameras kill those things, I'd be set.
As we can't use the this is a lot like the one that I used from a pre-show for my first run of Resident Evil 2. That orchestra rendition of the safe room. All right, so what was it? 9:15:07. Oh, hi, chicken. Nice. I'll take it. She's not here. Nope. She is probably somewhere else.
Carlos, the Star's office is up ahead.
Copy that. Fuck's sake, why is it blocked?
Can we go up here? No, that's somebody else. Damn it. No! Leave my ankles alone! Ooh, hello. Nice. You're probably gonna... Oh, this room hasn't been blown in yet. Really? Learn something new every day. Thank you, chicken. A different one. Why is it giving me that thing in the upper left corner? I can come back. Shit. I need to get it from there anyways. If you're reading this, I'm already dead. If you hear any noises coming from the locker, do not open it, please. While you're out of control, I focus on a way to get to the other side. Realize explosives might be our best bet. Managed to rig up a pretty good bomb. We don't have any batteries or the detonator. Pretty sure I sent one to the safety deposit room. Your buddy Wes. Don't worry about that 600 I lent you. Think of it as a gift towards your upcoming move. Good luck, buddy. Hector. Yeah, do not open dead inside. I'm pretty sure it's one of the... I think it's this one right here.
Okay. Guess we'll be doing this the exploding way.
Indeed. There we go. Flash. He writes on a sticky note, "Remember me as a hero." This may be blind, but they're not deaf. That blastable theory. It's good to know that I can counter those as well, so that's nice little lesson there. Alright, this is not exactly Revenge Part 2. This is more of like a Take 2. This is a director's cut. Nope! Now it's Revenge Part 2. Thank you. do me a solid and sing this Queen song along with me. Flash! Ow. Okay, that hurt. What was that blast? Was that the flashbang doing a second? Because I saw something spark. Give for a shotgun or some incendiaries. Hell, I'll even take cans of fizz. I whiffed that. Okay, that was interesting. I didn't see any, like, prompts for that part. Was that, like, automatic? Because it didn't give me, like, the extra struggle kind of thing. I like to think I got the timing for that right. Oh, great. The keys are still missing. Don't tell me I have to find those. So we have the one. We don't have the three. We can do 104, 106, and 109. Oops. Ooh. Wait, is there anything in these other ones? Alright, given the fact that there's nothing in these other ones, we probably don't have to find the keys. I think it's just for all of these. Where'd you get a hand grenade? There we go. Okay. Problem solved. Third floor locker. DCM. Okay. Why are you giving me that symbol again? Nice. Very tempted to open this just to see what happens.
Carlos, I've hit a dead end with the terminal here. Gotta head your way.
Copy that.
Hope curiosity doesn't kill this cat.
Better not.
Oh, okay. Smart.
Gotta move.
Blammo! Ah, and that's why everything is leaking. Oh, hi. Oh, shit. Right behind me. Shit. Oh. I was like, what am I getting stunned by? It was the steam. The explosion blew the steam pipe, that's why it's cut off in Resident Evil 2. Alright, so. It's a good thing I raided those lockers. Because if we got just the thing for that. Thank you.
Copy that. Better not.
So I wonder, if he doesn't pick up the file for that, will he try to open it?
Gotta move.
So he says the same thing? Okay. And blammo! Wow, you got fucked up.
One at a time, take a number.
Ah, dang it. Damn it, no! I'm dead. God, that was a lot in there. That had to have been like more than 8 of them. Part 3.
I've hit a dead end with the terminal here. Gotta head your way.
Copy that. time, take a number.
There's one more in there, I know. Does this actually have burst fire? Or am I just not holding the trigger down for it to do that? Because it's not like Leon's Matilda where it just like steady bursts, but still. I'm not complaining though. Health spray! No, it doesn't have burst fire. Let me guess, it probably needs an upgrade. Yeah. Why would it say it has that option if it's not gonna do it? Damn it! Where'd it leave me at? Do I have to do a whole freaking bathroom again? I mean, why give him a Glock to 18 if it's not gonna have the automatic fire? Which, by the way, the Glock 18 doesn't even have burst fire. It's either semi-automatic or full auto. So what is this, part four?
Carlos, I've hit a dead end with the terminal here. Gotta head your way.
Copy that. Gotta move.
Oh, God damn it. Come to think of it, maybe hardcore's too much for a first run.
Really?
Wait, what's coming up later? It's the Hunters, isn't it? It's the frickin' Hunters. Alright, part 5. Maybe the grenade will actually kill them for once. We won't really know until it actually happens. That's the sucky part about it. I think if I reach part 10, then it's probably going to be considered red line.
Carlos, I've hit a dead end with the terminal here. Gotta head your way.
Copy that. One at a time, take a number.
Damn it! I was hoping you would be able to, like, follow up with that, but whatever. Oh, come on! Stay down. this place is completely blocked off. I don't have the key for this. There we go. Nice. Where am I hearing the bobblehead?
Dr. Bard.
Paul, thank God. Do you know how long I've been trying to reach somebody?
Don't worry, we're gonna get you out of there. Just tell me where you are.
I'm trapped in a goddamn hospital, surrounded by every kind of abomination. Look, just send in stars. They're gonna know what to do.
No, negative. RPD's overrun too.
Then figure it out! Umbrella's gone crazy. They're killing all the researchers. I am the only one who knows how to make the vaccine to stop the zombies. So you can either sit there with your dick in your hand or send somebody who's capable of getting me the hell out of here.
I like him already.
Yeah, you would. You heard what he said. We can't turn him over to the company.
That's not our call to make. That's Mihail's call. I'm gonna check the computer, see if I can trace the doc's location.
Oh, hey.
This'll take some time. Look around, see if you can find anything useful.
It's Chris's jacket. This would be Jill's desk. So it has the picture of her dog, or someone's dog. Oh, good. Those. Rebecca's bag. Hey, we got a health spray. Thanks, Rebecca. Actually, just in case. Wesker's office. Report on the mansion incident rejected. This bizarre incident occurred in a mansion owned by the Umbrella Corporation located in the Arklay Mountains. On July 23rd, STARS Bravo team was dispatched to the Arklay Mountains to investigate a series of mysterious and grisly murders and went unexpectedly radio silent. On July 24th, Alpha team was dispatched as well and became entangled in the events at the nearby mansion. The incident culminated with the destruction of the mansion. Casualties were numerous. The only survivors were five members of STARS. The cause of the incident was the illegal bioweapon experiments being carried out in a secret umbrella lab beneath the mansion. The T-virus being used in these experiments escaped the facility and is presumed to be the root cause of all that occurred. However, all evidence was destroyed along with the mansion, so further investigation was proven to be extremely difficult. Five, so that's Jill, Chris, Barry, Rebecca, and Brad. And they don't know that Wesker survived.
Is that Jill in the front row?
Yep. There's the old concept art from the original PS1 version of Resident Evil. That was before Rebecca even joined. Now, can we interact with a drawer here? I don't think we can. Sorry, Mike, no secret picture of Rebecca. What's this? Nice. But somebody left this open. Any good toys for us? None. Or... nope, just ammo. No toys. They're all for Leon and Claire. Not even something left behind by Barry. Just a bunch of gun boxes. I can trash this. Thanks, Brad. Around here. Just a box. No, there's no typewriter here.
Yeah, what's up? Derailed. Is anyone hurt?
Jill?
Ah, shit. Wait, what? Jill! Jill, what happened? Jill, come in! T, I gotta go.
Do what you gotta. I'll take care of Bard.
September 29th, 4:43 a.m., Star's office. So, Leon and Claire don't arrive until the 30th. Carlos Express. Grenade launcher with looks like flame rounds, explosive rounds. Got the shotgun, only 5 rounds left, or 5 shells, rather. 58 rounds, 9mm. Favorite line of the whole game is coming up. Is it, what's this? Mine rounds? Flies to its target on its own propulsion, detonates after a short period of time or if approached. Now, will this only attach to enemies or can I stick it on a wall? I'd like to think I'd be able to stick it on a wall. Weaponry notice. Good news, limp dicks. I've got some new weaponry for you that's guaranteed to put the brass back in your sacks. They're called mine rounds. These babies were developed by Umbrella's military R&D. They will light your fires hotter than the lover you left back at home. Tough to find and tricky to handle, but trust me, they're worth it. Alright, let's take a look at the specs. Mine rounds are designed for standard issue grenade launchers. Don't get cute and try to load them in anything else. Fire them at walls or on the ground, and they'll stay right where you put them. Sensor in the mine will detect approaching enemies and detonate when they get within range. Okay, so it's proximity. So basically, just toss them in an enemy's path and you got yourself a landmine. There's no such thing as unfair when you're taking on those giant freaks, so get out there and fight dirty. Alright, so this line, is it Susie's favorite line, or is it something else? We'll save off on the gunpowder. Oh, so that's where they put it. She says that means something big is coming, and I'm not going to enjoy it. Do I have grenades? Got flame rounds. Ah, damn it. I probably should have used the mine for that one. Here we go. Okay, it's very short range. Interesting. That's okay. At least we know how that works. Damn it. Alright, let's do a do-over. I mean, if it's giving me those mines, might as well have to make use of it. Oh, is that the clock tower? That apparently got cut from the game? Of a weird place to have barracks, but whatever. Yeah, there's nothing down here except for zombies, so. Really? That did it. Interesting question. If I shoot a mine, can I shoot it with a handgun? Because I remember in Resident Evil 4, when you had the mind thrower, you could actually set it off early by shooting it with something else. It's gonna come out the water. Something on the bench. Oh, right here. Thank you. Else around here aside from a possible jump scare. Clock tower brochure. St. Michael's Clock Tower is a Baroque style building which stands at the heart of Raccoon City. It's become a beloved icon and residents consider it to be to be emblematic of the city as a whole. St. Michael's Church erected this tower in 1908 with the assistance of several philanthropists. It was dedicated to the children born of the developing city, and the first floor was used as an elementary school for many years. The city saw further growth during its electrification over the course of the early 20th century, and the student body of St. Michael's Elementary swelled to over 600 students. Fortunately, St. Michael's Elementary was shuttered in 1978 as a building began to show signs of age and wear. The clock was deactivated, and strict limitations were placed on the entry to the surrounding premises. Years passed since with this once beloved monument in the public plaza on lockdown, but in the 1990s, the Umbrella Corporation worked in league with Mayor Michael Warren to renovate and reopen the area. This time, with proper preservation efforts in place, the clock tower was officially reopened in 1993, and today the sound of its heavy tolling bells can once again be heard throughout Raccoon City. Oh, hello. A little wine to wind down the day. One glass, please. Okay, that's all of it. Oh, don't tell me I gotta fight this thing on a bridge.
Respond.
Yeah, what's up?
We didn't make it. The train derailed.
Derailed? Was anyone hurt?
No, everybody's dead. Mikhail, everybody. Nikolai left us to die.
Wait, what?
What the fuck? It's back!
Chill. Chill, what happened?
That's a huge bitch! Started to look like a giant, starting to look like a giant licker. Ow. Ow. Super weed. Anything counts, anything works, I will use it. What are you doing?
Ow. Circle around. There we go. Ow. Oh, that thing? Okay. This has got like a little Las Plagas kind of thing that pops out. Interesting.
Oh, come on.
All right, what do we have? Okay, this is right from the beginning. Oh, okay. Oh! Oh! How am I still alive? Oh, ow, okay. Oh, there's all the stuff over there. Ow. Come on. Shit, why is she dodging? I'm just like timing that out terribly.
Stutter.
Again, how am I still alive? Never mind, now I'm dead. Took a tour of duty in Vietnam, nom 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 nom. Insert Cookie Monster sound here. You're supposed to get the bread, that way you have a Jill sandwich. Missing some important ingredients there, Nemi. Too early for that one. Alright, I'm gonna give this take this opportunity to get everything. Such as the super weed. One mine. But right here. Where is he? Oh! I was like, he stopped moving. mine rounds. I need mines. That's not mine rounds. God dang it. Oh shit, nope, nope, nope. Don't let it be a kill. It's a kill. We got this, we got this.
Come on.
Did I just miss it? Oh, no, don't. You're a dick. Too early. Oh, come on. There we go. How are we looking? No. Not so hot. There's gotta be more. No, no, that's not it. Thank you. Oh, god damn it. Damn it. Ah! You stop crowding me, please. Social distancing. There we go.
Right, let's do this. Stop it! Carlos, you still there? Oh, come on, you're gonna crap out on me now? God damn it.
All right, see if there's anything else for... Nope, it's completely empty. Shit. All right. That can't be good. That cannot be good at all. Last thing I need is to be screwed over. I don't even know why I'm looking around. This place has already been cleared. Oh, is this how she gets infected?
Interesting. You've done me a big favor, Miss.
Oh, she's having a full-on seizure. Roughly half a day? Jesus Christ.
Jill!
I don't feel so good.
Hey, answer me. God damn it. Tyrell, do you copy?
What's going on?
Jill's been infected. I'm taking her to the hospital. Maybe Dr. Bard can save her.
All right, I'll meet you there.
in there, Super Cop. I got you.
Oh, we're getting the piggyback ride from Carlos. I'm assuming that's where she would have said, if you want stars, I'll give you stars. But I guess they probably might have moved that to the end, like in the original. Oh. Because the way she came at the Nemesis with the grenade launcher felt like it would have been that moment. You're already at the part a few times before when she says it.
I'm gonna get you the vaccine.
Oh, when she tries to distract the Nemesis away from the train.
Okay. I promise.
Aw. Got time. But alas, comes the part that I have been dreading for quite a while now. Happy fucking birthday. Aspirin, as opposed to aspirin. Was that supposed to be super aspirin? I'm gonna take this health spray with me. Jill, can I borrow your shotgun? Not that place. Oh. Save aspirin. There you go. Wash your hands. Practice safe distancing. Safe social distancing. Wear a mask when you go into public places. For God's sakes, cover your damn mouth. Only a 10% chance of turning you into a roided out mutant. Shit, okay. I'm guessing Jill goes through here. That. Do I have a grenade? No. Oh, there's three of you. Oh, dang it. Just that split second. Stay down, please. What did I just say? Delaying the inevitable, I know. But the less I see of them, the better. Great, so now I gotta go outside. I'm gonna miss that number being so low. It's probably gonna jump into the triple digits for a while. Assuming that the game is keeping true. Cause for all I know, it might not have changed this whole damn time. It might be in someplace else. What? Nurse's Journal, September 25th. Every day they bring in more of these mystery illness patients. These sedatives won't stop their delirium, so we have to put them in straitjackets and move them to the isolation wing. Problem is, the isolation wing is already bursting at the seams. The director has ordered us to admit anyone with symptoms free of charge, but what does he expect us to do? Wish them better? We don't have a cure. And that's not all that's bothering me. When these patients die, they're not collected by the usual mortuary teams. We've been told it's special handling to prevent the illness from spreading, but I'm not sure I buy it. Miranda saw some guys wheeling a body through the forbidden door during the night. Why? Where? What's going on? What's with the freaky music?
Dr. Bard, are you in there? I'm here to rescue you. Open the door.
No voice match found.
Voice match? What kind of sci-fi bullshit is this?
Grand. Just fucking grand. I wish I had a grenade for all this. Why aren't they moving? Oh, now they are. Oh, it's probably because I'm in the door. It's probably closed right behind me now. Oh, shit. I thought I got both of them. Nope. Yeah, do me a solid and just stay right there. This is not good. Jesus Christ! I don't have a key card. This is not good at all. What I would give for a shotgun. It's locked. Healthy family is a happy family. Got any birthday cake up in this bitch?
7th, admitted over 20 mystery illness patients. Patients in the isolation wing exhibiting severe limb necrosis, fever, muttering delirium, and signs of hyperphagia. Possible infection. Tried to be antiseptic. Tried every antiseptic. Still no blood work from back from the research wing. Ask again. Dr. Yuna was bitten while treating one of the patients. We disinfected the wound, but his fever won't go down. Nothing works. Meanwhile, the outpatient wing is complete anarchy. Patients are delirious and growing more violent by the minute. We've called in our off-duty staff. It's all hands on deck now. We've got to contain this chaos. Not a whole lot. All that excitement, it's only been like 10-15 minutes. Thank you. Tried, I swear to God we did, but there's nothing else to be done. The chaos is completely beyond control. The victims are pouring in now, dying and spreading the infection faster than we can reach them. So we've given up on trying. Those of us who aren't infected have barricaded ourselves in here. We hear the cries for help outside, the screaming, but none of us will go out there, because it'll be the end of us. I can't believe we've abandoned our patients. It's the worst sin imaginable for a nurse. Can't stop shaking, but I want to live. I want to live. We heard a helicopter flying overhead and immediately started crying and hugging each other, thinking the rescue team was on the way. But then the sound grew distant, and all we're left now is the moaning of the dead and silent screams in our hearts. We're all about to lose our minds. Dr. Young, Ariana, Miranda, Dakota, I'm sorry I failed you. Something's coming. Help him. Lockpick for those. Jesus Christ, that's a lot of them. They had a cherry donut party and got out of hand. I wish there were some donuts. Memos from administration. ID cards are not to be taken off hospital grounds under any circumstances. As per our security measures, all employees must store their ID card in their own personal lockers before returning to home, returning home for the day. Thank you. The keys to the locker room has gone missing. The last person may have dropped it somewhere in the courtyard. Until it is recovered, we will keep a spare key here in the office. Please stop by administration at the end of your shift to borrow it. Because I can't get in here. I gotta go to the courtyard. By the time I come back here, all of these guys will come back.
Okay, not this way.
This is really gonna suck. I'll come back. Oh, geez. Greatly reduces recoil, okay. Is it me or is that the same animation for jumping barricades back in the old, like Resident Evil 4 and so on? Is there a door? There's another way over. No. So where does that put me?
Alright, so where else can I go? What do I have? I've got the key that goes to the staff room. Not liking this at all. All right, so where was that one place that I found? I had to make sure there's a no other way. I was not expecting to jump off of there. I think I get it now. Or is there another way out down there? Oh, there is. It's right there. Okay. To get my bearings right. Yeah, that's the way I gotta go to. So let me check that other room. Locked. Okay. So what's someplace that I haven't been to yet? Let's go to the staff room. Nice hat. Ooh. Dick move. Total dick move. An even worse dick move. So I've got the ID card. Where do I need to go for that? Voice lock. No! No! Shit! I'm not happy. I'm not happy, and I'm not stopping here for the night. We're gonna try and get through much of this, as much of this as possible. Because I do not want to go through this bullshit. Think. What was that locked by? You can't see, but my eyes are like super wide right now. to be here. I think I know what happened to the missing tape of Dr. B. His research assistant took that one of my patients saw Abbott remove something from the locker in the nurse's station, walked toward the treatment room. I'll try to sneak in and look during the night shift. You stay cool, keep doing your job. I don't care how important Dr. B is to the medical community. That kind of harassment is not okay. I won't let him destroy the evidence. He's a pig and an asshole, and we'll get his day in court. Stay brave, stay strong, a friend. Okay, treatment room. Where's the treatment room? Treatment room's right down here, where I heard the frickin' hunters. Stay back, please. You have got to be shitting me. Jump through the glass. Don't jump through the glass. Oh yeah, it's super fantastic. God damn it. Sweet. Stay down, please. But now that they heard that, I probably pissed them off and they're gonna come busting through the goddamn walls or through that door or whatever the fuck it's gonna do. It's gonna give me a goddamn heart attack. And how are you still alive? Ah, damn it! Oh, come on! This is probably going to be a stupid idea. Oh god, there's more of them. There's fucking more of them. Alright. Oh, come on, that didn't work? There we go. Excuse me. God dang it. Damn it. Everything in there. I got some ammo, but I don't know if that was really worth it. Whatever. Alright, what exactly is the mechanic for the punch? Is it gonna do I have to hit them as they're lunging at me? Stay down, please. It's the same as the dodge. She's getting back up, isn't she? Okay. Now what is not so nice is dealing with that shit. But I have a plan. It's probably a stupid plan, but a plan nonetheless. Some. Oh, okay. They can straight up dodge me. It's a good thing I saved, though. But those things are fucking bullet sponges. That's an instant kill? Okay, so it's exactly like the decapitation lunge from the old games. Nice to know they kept that in there. keep them bottlenecked in here. Oh, geez. They are fast as fuck. One. Where's your buddy? Where the fuck did he go? Okay, the glass isn't broken. There's no holes in the ceiling. I mean, they can open doors, but that's pretty barricaded. Out of existence? I hope so. One less to worry about. Also, I used to have a TV like that. So there's one around here unaccounted for. I don't know where the hell he is. There he is. Come on. Just give me the chance. One second. That's the last of them. I doubt it is. No, that is not the way. I'm taking a gamble going this way. Is there one down there? Crap, there's a lot of them. Oh, come on! Oh, that killed me! All of it, or is there more? There we go.
All I wanted to know was what the documents were doing in your office in the first place.
Who do you think you're talking to? I'm goddamn Nathaniel Bard. I'm the best biologist you'll ever meet, you bedpan-changing waste of a nursing degree. Of course I have connections higher.
That being said, don't disrespect nurses. Sure, it's the doctors that'll help you get cured. But in reality, it's the nurses that help your ass recover in the mean while you're there.
Bard.
Tyrell. Bard's dead. He's been shot.
Shit. And the vaccine?
I'm looking.
Gotta be a computer, right?
Banquet invitation. This is, yeah, nurses do more work than the doctors anyway. Dear Dr. Bard, it is my pleasure to quarterly invite you to a banquet on September 10th at the Central Hotel, where we'll be exchanging viewpoints on Raccoon City's new special medical zone. Attending will be Mayor Warren, Chief of Police Brian Irons, and other distinguished members of our community. Thursday, September 10th, 1998, Oriental Restaurant, Central Hotel, second floor, would be honored to join us. Greg Tester, United States Senator. Handwritten note, Nate, I'll be introducing you the bill for that new drug of yours in mid-August. Bring the cash. We booked the site for the usual after party. You're the brunette guy, right? I'll let Irons know. They are preparing me for more war. Email from Anthony Bard. Reply immediately. Greg, I know you're watching the news. The virus is going to devour the whole country. The dead will wash over Capitol Hill like a tidal wave. You are not safe. However, you've always been a good friend to me, so I'd like to offer you a way out. I have in my possession one dose of a vaccine for the virus, the Holy Grail. It's not for my family, not for my ladies on the side. No, Greg, I'm saving it for you. I know better than anyone that you're the future of the United States, but if you want the goods, Greg, you've got to get me the hell out of here now, without Umbrella finding out. Lean on the Pentagon for me. I know you've got a clout. See if someone can get a rescue team here, in here without UBCS involvement. You scratch my back, I scratch yours, which should sound pretty chaste after the parties we've been to. Hurry, my time is running out.
This is VRC Chief Nathaniel Bard, September 29, 11 p.m. I am acutely aware that my time's running out. And I hope and pray, by making this recording and bringing the truth to light, that I can restore some small shred of honor to my name. All of Raccoon City's suffering began with the release of a biological weapon known as the T-Virus. My employer, the Umbrella Corporation, engineered this virus. And they ordered my team to develop a vaccine, which we did. Now, I keep samples of this vaccine here in my office. The rest of it is stored underground. But those sons of bitches at the board, they want to destroy it. They don't want the world to know what they've done. So they're trying to erase all evidence that the virus ever existed. I'm not a fool. I know they don't want me to...
Nikolai.
God, Jill knew all along. And she trusted me anyway. Fuck!
Why did that unlock suddenly?
Is it here?
Hmm. Look at the 90s webcam. Oh yeah, I used to have one of those.
T, I got it.
Good, I'm headed your way.
Be careful.
Careful? Have you seen this town? It'll be a fucking miracle if I get there in one piece.
Alright, so where's the nearest? Shit, the nearest one is all the way at the beginning. Crystal clear, 144p resolution, right? Motherfucker! So that's where the one that ran off went to. I guess. I hope. Wait, what's that over there? Oh yeah, that's right, it's a box. Time for this.
You're gonna be okay, Joe.
Yeah, I probably should. It's a good thing I saved, but you know, we'll go ahead and stop here. We're gonna have to let you suffer until next week, Jill, sorry. Good lord. But that was probably the worst of it, I think. Because I only know the hunters were only in that part of the game. At least in the original. So. But there is. Looks like there's going to be a section where we go through here as Jill anyways. So it's probably not over. That being said, we'll pick this up again next week. Tomorrow, we got more for the birthday celebration. Quote unquote celebration. We'll probably be doing some stuff on GTA. Update on what we'll see on that. I'll be fine. She can't wait. Incubation period, 14 days. I wish. But luckily, we haven't seen anything like that with COVID. Knock on wood. But, yeah, tomorrow we'll probably do some GTA stuff. Wednesday, we'll come back with the finale of Death Stranding. we're gonna push to finish it. I might start early if it comes to that. Probably start like 11:30-ish. Not sure if I'm gonna do anything on Thursday. Friday we'll be coming back with more Final Fantasy VII, and then we'll come back with more Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order on Saturday. If you like that stream, head on over to Bravo's site for more information. Although I still need to fix the problem I have with the stream feed on the front page. But other than that, I gotta finish. I think I might have to do some more updates to it. It is somewhat updated, but we'll see. You can also find my archive over there. Take this off. And if you got any burning questions, comments, or complaints that you would like me to know about, or any suggestions you might have for me for future Let's Plays, Let's Tries, Johnny Versus, or WTF Gaming, head on over to the contact page and shoot them out to me over there. Also, scroll down below or off to the side, depending which platform you're watching from, to catch the rest of the lazy streamers, along with a couple other streamers that I like to watch. Check them out whenever you can. You won't be disappointed. Again, thank you for joining me tonight, and I'll catch you guys tomorrow. Actually, I don't even know if we're going to be streaming this. If we are, I'll let you guys know. But if not, it'll probably just be having fun. If not, you guys have a great Tuesday, and I'll see you guys on Wednesday. So, take care. Love and hype. Life was stressful, but it couldn't have been worse. You didn't get a panic bark out of me, at least not yet. So, yay, something to look forward to. Life is good. Good night, everyone.